Hey, what's up? John Sonmez from SimpleProgrammer.com. So I got a question here. I think this is pretty interesting. I'm going to kind of twist this question around. But this question is from David, and he says, I'm trying to get my first programming job. I have already found my niche, CUDA. That's C-U-D-A. I absolutely love working in CUDA and can't wait to get up every day to start on it. But as a pretty small niche, there aren't a whole lot of jobs in it, and fewer still that aren't looking for someone with a master's slash PhD and a ton of experience. I'm willing to relocate and I'm casting a wide net, but it still may take a lot of time before I find employment as a CUDA developer. I'm at no risk of starving or being kicked out of my home, but the financial stress of not having a job is really starting to get to me. So I'd like to hear your thoughts on taking just any programming job today versus being selective and waiting for one that will put me directly into my chosen field. Thanks for all that you do, David. So this harkens back to the old debate of specializations. I'm going to just give the playlist of all the videos I made on specialization, because I always talk about you need to specialize, and this is no exception. So here's the thing that I did when I got this email, is I went and I just typed CUDA into Google. I didn't actually know what it was. I thought it was some kind of graphics thing, and I was right. It's a graphics programming language. I don't even honestly know exactly what it is. I didn't do a whole bunch of research on this, but I think it's Nvidia puts out this CUDA API framework for doing graphics development. And lo and behold, I went to an Nvidia site, and there was a whole community around it and support for developers. And immediately I thought to myself, well, that's interesting. There's a lot of hits on this CUDA thing, and there's, I mean, Nvidia specifically, they're developing this technology. I believe it was Nvidia. So, of course you can become a CUDA. This is really good, actually, right? So you can specialize in this. So, I guess where I'm getting at this is I want to say, basically, that when it's very specific like this, it's really easy to find the companies that would hire these developers. And so just you know, you got to kind of play this out. I want to kind of give you the thought process. So I Google for the thing, I see CUDA, I see Nvidia. So then what might I do next, right? So my thought is, well, I could reach out to, I could look at the forums they have in the community, get involved in that community there, start answering questions, start seeing what kind of questions they're asking. And then as I developed a reputation there, I could probably contact some of the Nvidia employees that are working there. And Nvidia has a vested interest in having companies use CUDA and developers know CUDA, right? So if you were to ask them, if I were to ask them and say, hey, where could I find, what kind of companies are hiring CUDA developers specifically, I bet they have a big long list. See where I'm getting at, right? You got to follow the trail. So this is, and I'm using this example, but it doesn't just apply to CUDA, right? That's why I'm using this specific example. But whatever that niche is that you're like, well, you know, it's too specific. No one is going to hire someone in this niche. It's just that you got to find the trail and figure out with the difficulty that you're having trying to find a job in a specific niche is the same difficulty mirrored that a company is having trying to find a developer that knows that specific thing. Think about it. Let's flip this around. If you are a company that is working with this CUDA framework, right, and you're trying to interview developers and you're looking for developers that have CUDA experience and you can't find any, how frustrating is that, right? They're going through the same struggle on the other side as you are. So you got to find where the community is and where you can find that connection point, and you got to make yourself become prominent in that community. That's why, again, sign up if you haven't already for my How to Create a Blog to Boost Your Career course, and create a blog and start becoming the expert in that area. I guarantee if you have a CUDA blog, right, and you're helping other developers and you are becoming the go-to person on this technology, especially. You can niche it down even further, right? A specific aspect of that technology, pick something out in that whole CUDA space. If you have that, if you're in the community, if you're answering Stack Overflow questions about CUDA, right? If you're going to all the places where companies are using that that library and that framework, and you're answering questions there, and you become well known there, then you're going to find those companies, and they're gonna hire you. You're gonna become the expert in that area. The key, though, is to find those places. And like I said, and look at it. I wouldn't just call up Nvidia out of the blue, right? You got to establish yourself a little bit. You know, play around in the community. You know, ask some questions, but you could ask them certainly for leads. They're gonna have a list of their customers, of their clients. They want more developers to start using this. So you're helping them by learning more, by teaching more developers. Tell them that you want to teach developers, you want to get more people excited about CUDA, right? That's the key. So again, this is very specific, but I want to give a specific example so that you can now apply this to whatever technology that you're working with. You know, and see that the same. It's going to be extremely high value when you make that connection. It's going to be a little bit more difficult. So yeah, so don't just take a regular programming job. Do the CUDA thing, but make sure that you find the right place. Don't just start looking for CUDA jobs, because you're not going to find that. They're not going to be advertised on Monster or Dice. Instead, look for the companies that you know are going to hire CUDA developers, and then present yourself there and make sure that you've built up a reputation. And then you're going to have success. So good question. And if you have a question for me, email me at john@simpleprogrammer.com. And if you like these videos, subscribe to the channel. Take care.